Thank you for being at any case, 9:30. And this gentleman beside me, most of you know very well, as I mentioned, he is the founder of strategic and managerial force behind Boone Capital, one of America's most successful.
Speak up.
The investment companies, and he's the architect of the savings plan, which reduces our dependence on foreign oil. After leaving about 3:15 or so, should I ask you questions?
You all move up closer, so I can see you, hear me, and I can hear. I don't hear as well as I used to.
I've heard a little bit about your plan, know a tiny bit about it. What does it mean for automotive retailers? And what does it mean for the infrastructure of the country where the natural gas is used?
Well, let me start at the first, is we have a security issue for this country. And that is that we're dependent on oil from countries that are our friends, some are enemies. That is not small. When we do have a resource here that can solve the problem, natural gas, which is cleaner, it's cheaper, it's abundant, it's ours, and can do anything from gas and diesel. Now, when you say automobile dealers, I'm not here to sell the guys today on switching over to natural gas. I mean, we're going to use gas for a long time. But what I'm targeted on is 8 million 18-wheelers. And those 8 million vehicles can be moved to natural gas over a period of about 7 years. And if that is the case, you'll cut OPEC in half. And we're imported by main barrels of OPEC today. And in 7 years, we can cut 8 million heavy-duty trucks. That will send a message. What I want the president to do, and I hope for it, to get it in the state of the union, is that all new vehicles purchased by the federal government would be on domestic fuel. So that would send a message that we are serious about what we're doing, and we are going to get on our resources. And so that's where I'm coming from. Infrastructure, it'll come with the vehicles. You order the vehicles, the infrastructure will be there. And it's, I'm not big on R&D because R is 10 years and D is 10 years. So it's that in my game. But I am interested in a working, successful model. And you can go to California, look at Southern California. When they decided that they had an air quality issue, and when they said, look, we're going to clean it up, they said, what's the biggest polluter? It is the diesel and trash truck. And take one diesel trash truck off the street, it's equivalent to 3 or 4 or 5 cars. So there's a problem. They said, okay, what's the incremental difference? Diesel to natural gas, 50,000. They said, okay, when you buy new, it goes to natural gas away from diesel. And that's the plan. The plan worked. And 70% of their trash trucks in Southern California. That is the same plan I'd like to use for AP. When you buy new, you have to go to the commission.
Mr. Pickens, we've been with you from the beginning. 3 years ago now, we believe in CNG. We believe in the plan. Over the last four automobile shows, Detroit, LA, Chicago, Washington, there's been only one mention of CNG, and that's by four in the Transit Connect, their little vehicle, and it's only a conversion. And we felt, and I imagine you feel, that after all of this time, energy, money, 3 years of your life, that there should be more stuff happening, more traction in the CNG story.
You say that, excuse me for interrupting, but you say that no traction, no
legislation. I didn't say no, I said more.
But what, listen, I am a long way down the track. I've cleared about 8 hurdles out of 10, and I think you'll have legislation before Memorial Day on this very issue, which will be in the House. It's H.R. 1835. It's a bill. It's written. Everybody knows the bill and everything else. I don't understand why more has not come out in the press, but that bill has 137 co-sponsors. I mean, it's ready to go to the floor. And in the Senate, in Senate Bill 1408, that bill is written, it is compatible with 1835. that will pass, and this all could happen very quickly. And it's a bipartisan issue, and this administration needs a bipartisan something.
This is the bill on 18-wheeler?
It's on 18-wheeler, yeah. This is what we call class 5 through 8s, and that's all 18-wheeler. And what it would be, it'd be $65,000 tax credit. That when they buy them, you're not forced out of your vehicle. You keep running out as far as you want to go. But when you buy, then you go to natural gas.
Now, they're already on diesel, which is, of course, a fairly efficient fuel, at least compared to gas. Is that really the best place to put your car on diesel products?
On the diesel? Mm-hmm. I view diesel as foreign oil. And we're importing almost 70% of our oil now. So it's, I think it's a perfect place because it's the bottom. Those are running 20,000-25,000 gallons a year on those vehicles. So I want the big ones that are using the most and get it over to my fuel.
Now, they're over the red trucks. I mean, the beauty of the system you have now, the freight trucks are all centrally fueled. If you have over the road diesel trucks up running on natural gas, they wouldn't have as many fueling points as a local fleet would. Is that a problem?
The way, the first meeting I had, you know, if you're talking to somebody and they're not interested, they're looking around and kind of wanting to get you out in the meeting. If you're with somebody that's interested in what you're talking about, they'll usually lean forward, you know, and if they got a pile, they'll loosen up the collar and get ready to talk business. Well, that happened to me in Phoenix with Swift, Jerry Moyes, and we were talking, and when he got down to really talking about LNG over the road, and you're talking about 3,000 miles east to west, and but how many stations does that take? 20 or 30 stations.
So, but you have to get cross out broken and operators on board.
That's okay. I think they're to put a LNG island in to a truck stop is $1.5 million. So you could, and one of the deals that I've looked at is 50 of those, $75 million. It's peanuts to what you're accomplishing. Because here, with competency, it's cut off 2.5 million barrels a day. You're talking about somewhere around, it's about $75 billion a year. It is to outflow money from the United States to OPEC. And that, you know, that is the biggest transfer of wealth in the history of mankind, because we're importing every day. Our oil costs, not all of it, but our oil cost is $1 billion a day in the United States.
So we have to subsidize the fuel?
You would own? No, not the fuel. Fuel's a dollar a gallon cheap.
I'm sorry, the truck stop operators. I mean, $1 million is $1 million. So how are you going to get them to install this if you really want to go ahead with this money?
Yeah. I've seen enough, I think. They're there. They understand it.
There's an ROI on this for them?
Pardon?
There's a return on investment for
sure
them?
Sure there is. You can't get anybody to do anything any other way.
You should have talked with them. They're on death's door. They've had two terrible years. And you know, and you're going to try to encourage them to go natural, use natural gas.
No, I didn't say that.
Eventually, aren't you?
That'll all come natural. I mean, you'll first start the heavy duty, and if what I'm talking about is what this country needs, is get on our own resources, it will come down to light duty before it's over. But maybe light duty is electric. I don't know anything American. I'm for it. I want to start out with heavy duty. And you know, when I met with Senator Obama, then Senator Obama, in August of 2008, while we met in Reno, Nevada, at a hotel, and he said, "Is there anything that bothers me about energy, that bothers you that I say about energy?" And I said, "Well, I have to laugh when you say you're going to have 1 billion plug-in hybrids in 10 years. You know, he's dipping up real quick and said, "Well, it takes something big." So I don't say things that I don't mean. And if I say I'm going to have 1 million, I said, "Okay, you look out on that parking lot, there's 1 million vehicles out there. Looks like a hell of a bunch of cars in it. It would be a lot of cars." I said, "Now you're president of the United States, step back and look at America. There are 250 million cars in America. If you're going to do 1 million plug-in hybrids in 10 years, he smiled, he said, "It's not very many." Hell no, it's not. You got to look at the problem for what the problem is. And that is almost 70% of the oil we use every day in America is imported. You got to got to get off of it. You've got to get on your own resources is what you have to do. And then you look at what resources you have. Well, if you got ethanol, did it work? Yeah, it's working. No question, it works. And it's ours. It's an ugly baby, but it's our ugly baby. And then you've got the natural gas, which goes to the heavy duty, and you can take it wherever you want it. But once this starts to go, it's going to all happen. You're gonna get the security issue. I can tell you this. I've been around a long time, as you all know. And America has never had an energy plan. Never had an energy plan. So 40 years, no energy plan. If today we go forward 10 years, no energy plan, you are going to be importing 75% of your oil. You'll pay $300 a barrel. That's where you're going to be.
But my question was, is your message going to fall on deaf ears considering your struggle, economic struggle you're doing?
Well, I don't know. Maybe. But they're going to hear what I say. They're going to hear what I say. And we're going to have to go to our own resources. Our whole country is going to be being struggled. But you can't pour out $1 billion a day to, you know, where? Who knows?
The magic wand, we asked this a couple of times ago. You prefaced the question by saying, isn't it time for you to get angry? And you said, not yet, you don't have to get angry. Seems now it's a year and a half later, we're in the same pickle we are, except for HR, I know, because we had that same conversation 2 years ago.
Okay,
I'm anxious.
Okay, I am too. Listen, I flew an airplane 329 hours. 629 hours last year. 629. That is a lot of flying. And I would say 75% of that was to promote the use of natural gas. The other 25% of the hours on that was to entertain my wife. She's shaking me. But no kidding, I'm selling this thing. I can't get mad. I can't get angry. I've got to sell, and I'm going to get it done. Give me, you'll have it by Memorial Day.
But you can't be disappointed. Are you disappointed in the Obama administration or the president?
They haven't done anything to help me. All I've got for it, listen, I'm into the White House with Ron Emanuel. He knows the deal. He said, Pickens, it can't be as simple as you make it. And I said, okay. I said, Ron, tell me. It's complicated. And ask me the questions and see how I answer. But it is that simple. One, you only have one resource. So you're not pawing around looking at different alternatives. You don't have one. You have one resource. Fortunately, it's the clean one. It's the cheap one. And that's our. But just stick with it and keep pushing it with the politicians. Ask them every time you get a chance.
What happens if we don't do this? That's the question. What if we don't do this?
Well, you heard about
this is a security issue. 75 billion dollars a year. What if we don't?
What if we don't do it? Right. I told you what would happen in 10 years. You'll be importing 75% of your oil. You're paying $300.
What does that mean to us?
We're going to have to cut short.
I'll tell you what it means to you as a country. You solve two problems if you don't do it. The two problems you solve were education and health care. Because you aren't going to have the money to do either one of them, because you're going to be fine.
Thank you all very much.
Thanks.